AngelHack is a series of events that we hold all around the world. And each one of these events are called a hackathon. And they're 24-hour coding competitions.
Coding is a really big deal. It's basically the best industry to be in right now is any sort of programming or technology. And coming to a hackathon like this, I mean, this is the center of it. This is the new economy right here.
I think hackathons are a place where you can take all these ideas that you have floating around in your head, and then you actually sit and you code it, and at the end you have something.
AngelHack forces you to really prune off distractions. You're able to, you know, connect with peers, bounce ideas off, and just get a lot of that energy and momentum going that really, you know, enables you to take something from start to finish in a day.
Instantly, you're going from an idea to actually building something, and it happens fast, and it's like a freight train, and sometimes that's the kick you need to really get things done and to really take that idea and that dream that you have and turn it into a reality.
The culture of hacking is an obsession with solving puzzles. It's easy to talk about, you know, how things are going to work and what you want them to do, but really to execute on that and not be derailed by a bug or something like that.
A hacker, even though it sounds really codey, yeah, that's one element of a team, but the team needs many things. You know, you need product management, you need UX, you need the front end, you need the back end. A hacker is a member of a unit.
To be around girls who enjoy the same things, who want to achieve the same things, it's really fun to like connect with them and like see what you can make of it.
There's people out there at all skill levels joining teams, and there's people who are launched startups and already have, you know, careers, and people who are here for the very first time.
The timeline for development at a hackathon, it's incredibly compressed, right? Because you want to do something really cool, but you've got 24 hours to do it. So a lot of times it starts with somebody that's got the idea. Everyone tries to do everything at once, and then you hit this wall where you go, oh crap, we're behind, we're not gonna be able to do this.
You're stressed, you're under pressure, you're usually thrown in with different personalities, and you've got to learn how to come together, you've got to learn how to operate quickly, and you most importantly have to learn how to do it under very tight timelines and typically sleep deprived.
So the judging process at AngelHack works by using our platform called Hackathon.io, and then as a team they submit a project, and then the judges will view the demos, and then they just simply rate them on a scale of 1 to 10.
As a judge, my responsibilities are to really kind of look to see what the teams have done in a short period of time in terms of creating really a disruptive application.
And now the winner of AngelHack, big round of applause for Come on up,
I just want the community to know that hackathons might seem like, oh, a lot of really good programmers go, but that's a myth. A lot of beginners also come to hackathons. So even though if you feel like you don't know enough, you should always make it a point to come to hackathons, because that's when you learn the most.
People may think that we walk away with prizes and that's like the biggest gain from the competition, but I don't necessarily agree with that. I think some of the ideas I collected from other people could be much more valuable than the actual prize.
I just think it's exciting to see a bunch of young developers come together and actually write software. Because when that happens, ideas are being created, companies are being created, you know, funds are flowing into those companies, and that ultimately will impact the local economy.
You never know at the beginning of the hackathon what's going to happen until it's all over. And it's at the end that you realize that no matter what, your life is going to be different in some way or another, and it's then what you do with that momentum.